check my resume.
Two bass, speed of glory.
My dick go hard, 8.
Wait, whoa.
True facts.
It's cool. All right, yeah.
Can't stop. Fuck around, make my 40.
Who this?
Yeah.
Oh, shit. You need a tissue. You drop a boy, new song.
I haven't heard this.
Make a back from the dead.
Welcome to the best show in the UK. We are. You can leave it up like that. We are the Pod Fellas delivering news on all things entertainment. But remember, all is art and all art is man-made in the image of motherfucking God.
What?
And with me today, I have a couple real niggas in the room. Got my guy Legacy, first of all. Legacy, what are you saying? Say hi to the people.
Yo.
Yeah, you can't see him on camera right now. He's trying to hide from you guys. We got DeAndre. You lot know him. You lot have heard his voice before. You heard his wild opinions. wild arguments. You've seen him multiple times. That's my nigga DeAndre, man. Oh, shit. D. I'm going to beep that out. Because you don't like your name being said.
Wow, it's already out there.
It's out there, yeah.
All right,
let's leave it out there. Because this guy's been moving like a spy. I don't know who I was speaking to. I think it was Paolo I was speaking to. And I was like, DeAndre moves like he's a spy. This guy, I know nothing about his life. which I respect, because nowadays niggas meet you one time and divulge everything about their life.
Yeah.
And I'm not that type of person. So when they expect me to say it back, I'm just like,
what did Paul say?
No, we just started laughing at that. Because we just laughing about it. Because I'm just like, bro, I didn't know, like, I swear to God.
Yeah.
Every time as well I speak to this guy, he's always offering me some, like, really wisdom type shit. I'm like, God damn, like, this nigga, like... I remember earlier, before we started recording, I was like, this nigga keep telling me shit that makes me question his age. Like,
yeah.
I'm like, how old really, really is this nigga? Like, well, that's my nigga DeAndre, man.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
For the first time on this podcast, DeAndre, do you want to do the intro? How do you look me?
Man,
I know you told me already, but just tell them how you met.
Well, I was strolling through the park with a basketball.
Yeah.
And I decided
That's how every black man story starts, by the way.
I decided to do a couple of dribbles. Yeah. Then I saw him.
Yeah.
And I was like, okay, cool, let's run a game. So yeah,
okay.
Yeah. Then I annihilated him.
Oh, wait, that's what you did.
And then yeah, I mean,
hey, I did a little size.
Huh?
A little size. Like, I was terrible. I was pretty bad. I was terrible, though.
So, to whose standard?
That's a good question.
I'll give you
actually.
That. I'll give you that.
Yeah. All right, so that's how you love me. I thought this was going to be like a wholesome. Like,
that was very wholesome, man.
Yeah.
Okay. I think I was very polite and direct with my answer. That's how we met. I mean, it was very truthful.
So you fucked him up on the basketball.
100%.
God damn. But like, I was looking for you to tell us the more positive part.
That was very positive.
I came out
with a W because.
Damn, you put me under the bus. Straight out.
I'm saying though, like, say the part where. Like you was coaching him and that.
Oh yeah, yeah. Nah. Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? I'm trying to alley you for the.
Nah,
for
see,
the
I wanted to leave
pushing each other, but these guys just want to tell you about.
I'll let Jordan say that.
Yeah, you still.
Oh well, how? Alright, so you know, just turned out. You know, we're playing. I lost. Pretty yeah. bad first time.
And then he was like, nah, you need some training.
Okay, yeah. Nah.
You need to work on a couple of things. I got this. Now I'm joking, God.
Yeah. So, you know, just met a couple of times. Turned out, you know, family, friends as well. So,
oh, okay.
Yeah.
So you already kind of knew of each other type of situation. Yeah. And then you got a bit closer.
Yeah, you got a bit closer. He was like, yeah, man.
Yeah, man. Sports are very important, bro. Mm-hmm. Like, especially... we don't say this a lot, but in the black community, I feel like sports saved a lot of niggas' lives.
Definitely.
Like,
definitely.
Even though we don't all, like, eventually become pro, but just for the fact that you was interested in that while you was a teenager, kept you away from some of the other shit that you could have been doing.
Nah, that's a fact. No,
you know
that's
what I'm saying?
For real.
And that's why, like, you say that lightly, but when you told me the story about how you was coaching him, that's kind of inspirational type of shit. Like, because you don't know what type of impact you had on his life. Because you probably both of you don't know what type of impact you have on his life just by doing that little simple thing. Story. Do you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And not everyone will do that.
Basketball, because I travelled a lot through when I was playing ball.
Yeah.
Finsbury Park, TPL, even the Jordan Centre in Vauxhall, fam. I travelled a bit for basketball.
You lot put me on game.
I travelled a lot and I met. It's like, you know, some guys like, yo, how do you know such and such people, this or these like-minded people? Basketball. Yeah.
That's what's up, man.
That was my therapy.
That's what's up, man. But...
but fuck that sport now, fam.
Why?
I told you, I was only playing to go pro, fam.
Oh, fair enough, and that didn't happen. I like to see the silver lining, I guess.
Still fuck that sport.
Yeah, it's pros and cons. But how's everyone's week been before I officially start?
It's been pretty good, man. You know, just going through. Yeah, same working
shit,
that.
Same
man.
Shit, different
yeah,
day.
Same shit, man.
How about
same
you?
Same shit, different day, bro.
How about you, DeAndre?
Agree.
Goddamn. Yeah. And that's it then, guys. That's a whole roundup of everyone's week.
Basically.
Same shit, different day.
Same shit, different day.
Like, what is it about niggas that we don't really, like, divulge in? You know, if this was three women here, and I just asked that same question, bro, we would have spent an whole hour unpacking how everyone's weeks went.
Yeah.
She would have told me about her co-worker that don't fuck with her, that she was a bitch too, but she's not going to tell me that part.
Yeah, but that's drama, man.
That's drama, yeah. I mean,
but that's what I'm saying, like, women, obviously that's drama, man, but they offer up information, innit? Yeah. But niggas are like, yeah, I dealt with that shit myself, like, you know what I mean? Because it's not like, same shit, different day. We all go through shit. But some days, some shit happens, that's just like, I ain't never really been through that before.
Yeah,
but niggas still never say it.
I mean, because it's like, bro, no one gives a fuck at the end of the day,
and
man.
That's my point. Like, niggas just feel like no one cares about me like that. Like, why am I?
Man's not gonna give you a whole.
You gonna be like, I don't care, my bro.
Yeah, like, bro, suck it up, man.
Yeah, man.
If I'm being real, that's probably true. Actually, I'm just asking for the podcast.
Yeah, man.
Alright, okay. Well, since we don't have any information about how our weeks went, and to be honest with you, like, I don't really got none for that either this week. But how you lot feel about letting other niggas fuck your girl?
It's never ain't gonna no happen. Way. It's ain't never no happening.
Ain't no way.
Niggas,
that's a crazy laugh.
Niggas get so sensitive when you start talking about the queen, bro.
Bro, not my baby.
What queen?
Okay. Man said queen.
All right. So would you rather she was fucking another nigga behind your back? Or you just going?
Neither.
I don't. But if you had to choose one,
single lifestyle, man.
Single.
All right. Okay. All right. I'm trying to have a conversation. All
right.
Okay. Right. Say for example, you start dating this girl.
Yeah.
Right.
I'm with you. Yeah.
And you look fall in love with each other.
I'm with you.
Yeah. And then you find out that while you lot was doing all the love shit, you've been dating for maybe five, seven years, long relationship, invested, thinking about having kids type of situation.
Yeah.
And then she's like, I'm not going to lie to you, bro. Your dick's not enough.
Whoa, wait.
Let me finish. So she says that, and then she's like, how do you feel about having an open marriage? Well, I can go out and have a one-night stand with a random guy that I'm never going to speak to ever again, and just to satisfy my sexual pleasure. Or maybe there's some shit that you don't do. You don't eat the booty, but she likes her booty eaten. And she's like, I have this booty eater on my phone. And he ready. I call him Friday nights. We do that. Nothing more, nothing less. You might not into that.
No.
No. Okay. No. Like, you actually lost me.
Yeah. Okay, that's so it. Would you rather her do that or her say to you, I mean,
I'm not choosing. Bro,
because your dick, no, I've been fucking this guy that you didn't know about. You've been fucking for 2 years. You don't have kids now at this point.
And she said that mortgage. To your face.
Yeah. Nigga.
I can't even lie. At that point, it's like...
Do you think these women have any compassion for us?
I mean, look at it like this, bro.
Boy, at that point, I'm like, is the kid even mine at that point? You saying you fucking this guy for 2 years? You got kids?
Wait, she has kids?
Yeah, apparently we got kids. Like, you've been here for like 5-7 years and she's been fucking a guy for 2 years. There's a chance of one of them kids and not mine.
Yours, yeah.
That is wild. I'm suing.
The argument that most women that I have conversations with, is that they don't like to come up with... Because I was talking to this girl. I'm not going to mention anyone's names anymore. Right. I was talking to this girl and she cheats on her boyfriend.
Mad.
Right? And I asked her, like, yo, why you do that? Like, don't you feel some type of way when you go home? Because this nigga don't know that she's fucking other people, right? Don't you feel some type of way when you get back home and, like, because she actually is in love with this nigga. That's the weird part. No, listen, that's the weird part for me. Because I'm like, you're laid up, not with me. You're laid up with other niggas, right? Mm. But while you're with other niggas, you're talking about your boyfriend, who you love a lot.
Mm.
Do you get what I'm saying? Like, you don't have a plan to live life together. Like, this nigga is a proper stand-up nigga. Like, I'm starting to feel bad for the nigga. Like, no. Do you get what I'm saying? But the reason why she would go out behind his back and fuck other guys is because she doesn't feel comfortable telling him that sexually she needs more. Does that make sense?
No.
So now she feels like...
No,
it doesn't. It doesn't make sense at all.
It makes a little bit sense to me.
That's
because
wild.
I've been in a relationship where I felt like her pussy was not enough. Or like the sexual shit that we was doing, after a while, wasn't enough to just be like, cool, I'm satisfied. Does that make sense?
You gotta have a conversation.
And in that moment...
You gotta have a conversation.
That's what I did. But as men, we're open to doing that with women. We're open to... I even suggested... I was younger. So I suggested having an open relationship. Obviously, she ain't going for that. But as a nigga, you would do that. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
That's why I was asking her, like, yo, you love this guy. You say you care about him. But
that,
listen.
Is that love word?
But she does. But she does actually love him.
It can't coincide.
She does. Do you know why I say she does actually love him? Because it's easier for her to just leave this nigga and just fuck all these guys that she's fucking already. Anyway,
that doesn't equal love.
I thought that's monkey brunching.
That's what?
Monkey brunching.
First,
like you just with a nigga and then you're looking for someone, a better option. And then when you find a better one,
you go where the grass is greener, innit?
Yeah.
I feel like you lot are misunderstanding what I'm saying. Okay. She's in love with this nigga. She's not trying to leave this nigga. All the other niggas
because,
she's seen,
yeah,
just
because what I'm saying is that doesn't equal love. That's just comfortability.
That's comfortable.
Yeah, thank you. You said it.
That's smart, man.
You said it. I was gonna say it.
At that point, it's just a habit.
Yeah.
That's like,
you know, wherever you go, you going back to this nigga.
Yeah. Like, I've got this person here, regardless.
So he's like a.
So you're telling me
it's like a savings account.
So yeah. So G, she can do that for 10 years.
Yeah.
My man's still gonna be there, fam.
I know, but that's what I'm saying. Then when she
wants to fully hang up, you know, the duties after shit been stretched, mileage.
Yeah, but he don't know about this. Yeah, to him, his girl is like.
But that's what I'm saying.
Like, yeah, but that's what I'm saying. The love and that can't coincide because
it can't.
That's cool.
You can't say that she don't love him though.
Yes, yeah, I can
because you can't be causing someone
actions and words
that amount of like. First of all, it's disrespectful, number one.
It is disrespectful. But the reason why she didn't tell him or she's keeping it away from him is because she don't want to hurt his feelings.
No, because she doesn't want to have an uncomfortable conversation. No,
that's a fact.
She's scared. No, she's a coward,
that's
basically.
True. That's true.
And that's
selfish. Women do that a lot. They blame you for not wanting to tell you the truth.
At this point, she's just building like, up right. the courage.
She's
not building up shit from...
On a real though, I did see some sense in her argument. Because you lot are saying that she's not in love with him if she's able to do that to him. But I argue that she is in love with him because she's doing that to him.
Wow.
And listen. Let me land my argument and maybe you lot might understand a bit more. So you're in a relationship with this guy for 7 years or for 5 years or whatever. So she had 3 or 4 years of that relationship where she wasn't fucking. It was just them, and you know what I mean? And then she realized that her sexual appetite is way more than he can give her. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
No, okay.
Instead of breaking his heart and leaving him and dumping him or whatever, listen. Instead of doing that, she decides to just start fucking niggas behind his back.
No.
But that's wild. That's, you got in reverse.
But is that not real love,
yo,
though?
But you know what? Stop.
Yo.
You're never going to convince her. Just stop. But you, man, let me play devil's advocate.
Yeah, go on. See, yeah, I'm starting to convince you.
No, you're not.
Go on.
You're saying that, right? Mm-hmm. And I kind of understand in via a woman's view, to them, that makes 100% sense.
That's what she said to me.
But to them, that makes 100% sense.
I was like, she kind of do got a point.
But the funny thing is, right, you might be saying like, oh, it's going to break his heart, rah, rah, rah.
Yeah.
She could tell him and he'll be like, I've been waiting for this day.
That's true, actually.
He could be ready for it. He could be ready for it.
Nah, then he's a plonker as well, because...
When you say ready for this day, you mean
he could be like, yeah, I'm down with it.
And so that he
but why does he need her to, like, that's a weird, that's, then you're a weirdo.
Or he might be like, oh, I'll try it. Yeah, like, we can go for it.
Hey, man,
that
like,
don't make sense, man.
For me, I wouldn't be in a relationship with someone that wants to fuck other people.
Definitely not.
I wouldn't do that. But I would fuck a girl who's in a relationship that her boyfriend allows her to fuck other people. Wouldn't you do that?
But you wouldn't know.
No,
you wouldn't know if the boyfriend allows her to do so.
Most of these women say it.
Exactly, because they say that, but is it factual?
No, but as in, it may not be. I don't know.
Is that?
But I can tell by their actions. If their boyfriend don't know about it, they're not picking up the phone while they're with me. They're not like texting the phone's screen down. There's a whole routine that they got planned, but
key word you said is if the boyfriend allows it.
Yeah, no, but boyfriend, that's what I'm saying. When the boyfriend does allow it, this bitch is picking up the phone like, yeah, no, I'm about to leave now. Yeah. Coming soon. Like, do you know what I mean? So okay. That's their agreement, and obviously I'm sure that he's over there fucking other bitches or whatever, like doing his thing. But when the guy don't know, that's when it gets a bit tricky.
Mm.
Do you get what I'm saying? And back to the conversation,
both of them,
how could you not see that this girl really does love this guy? Actually believe she does love him. I actually do. I'm not even just saying that just to trigger you guys. I think she actually does love him, but she doesn't want to face the fact that relationship could end because of how she feels sexually about their relationship.
Okay.
So then sacrifice your sexual urge, blood, if you love the Donny, bro. Do you know the amount of... Do you know the amount of sacrifice that you have?
Okay.
As the side nigga in this situation. So.
wait, what?
What?
Who?
You.
Oh, like, you did sound like you were the side nigga in this situation.
Man, we're so passionate about it. Okay. Hypothetically. Do you
just fucking put a nigga on blast?
Do you give her genuine advice?
Oh yeah, and that's why I'm actually having this conversation here.
Okay.
And I told her I was going to talk about it on the podcast, so it's cool.
And defend her honor.
Because
yeah, cool.
Hey man, I have to get some more pussy from her. So,
oh, like, well, that's crazy.
So like, you know what I mean? Yeah.
Not sure but anyway. That right. thing, fam. When she really loves a nigga, fam.
Hey,
when
man.
She clocks, fam.
But to answer, to
then
answer
she had a kid
question,
out of wedlock, fam.
Oh, good.
Nah, man. I'm always strapped up, bro.
No, I wasn't talking about you, fam. I was just
saying.
When you talk about kids, like that's a bit. Come making jokes like that. Like.
She ain't had a yeet yet, so I'm not making fun of the kids.
That's true. No, but I'm saying like, because when you say wedlock, I thought you was talking about.
I'm saying when my man finds out,
yeah,
and then yeah, she dips because it's like she's already like halfway out the relationship because she's doing that, yeah. Then she finds a nigga, then she gets cheated on and she might have a kid out, you know what I mean?
Oh, fair enough.
Yeah,
fair enough.
Mm.
But yeah, man.
I mean, I guess like that sometimes. But to answer his question, though, I do give her real advice, like, well, honest advice from my experience. Anyways.
Yeah.
Because that's what prompted me to come and ask you guys. Like, could a girl actually convince you to let her fuck
So she's going to listen to this?
No, no, no. I'm this is the advice that I gave her, actually, before we move on. You should tell him.
Yeah,
100%. Just tell him. Just tell him, yo, look, your sex game is not good enough.
No, don't say it like that.
Well, obviously, I'm saying it like the way a guy would say it. Obviously, a girl would, like, pamper a bit more and be like, well, you know, like, it just doesn't hit the G-spot. Whatever, like, you know what I mean? Explain to him that you're not satisfied and you're a bit more of a freak than what he can deliver. So, see if he's open to having an open relationship. Yeah, stop. But wait, why not?
Let me stop you there. Because you said, like, you're more of a freak than he can deliver, right?
Yeah.
Girls do this thing where, when they're in a relationship,
what's wrong with
they
that?
Don't want to be freaky because they feel like,
if
he's treating me like this,
it depends.
And then they let other niggas mash it out.
Hey, depends on the girl, bro.
It does depend.
I've been in a relationship with a girl where, like, she's the... Now, I mean, I was happy to go home to bed.
I'm telling you, it's not that.
But
it's not that.
I do get what you mean. Most women don't. They don't show out unless they've been at home.
I don't know why.
You don't
and
know
that's
what?
Why niggas I don't know love why. Hoes, bro.
Because yeah. it doesn't
and
make
that's
sense.
Why
it's so
niggas
backwards.
Love hoes.
Yeah.
It is very backwards. But they want you to spend
you
the rest of your
porn
life with
star
them.
Sex.
But still, the question remains, though. Like, what's wrong with her going with my advice and just...
Bro, everything
just
that came out of your mouth is wrong.
I can't lie.
Literally,
you've been saying
me, every word.
For me, though.
Questionable shit the whole time,
like, I wouldn't do that, but from listening to her and listening to what the dilemma is in her relationship.
The perspective is, you got to tell her, like, you got, like, if you're not, you just have to talk. Like, if you have to talk about it, yeah. But you can't say, I'm going to go fuck other niggas. Are you good with that? That's wild.
Yeah.
Because at that point, the thing's already done.
Okay, if you talk, okay, let's apathetically, you talk about that situation.
Yeah.
Your sex game's not good enough. Okay. Where else is it leading to?
You have to,
okay,
like, you have to
break
maybe
up.
You're better off talking about how to improve that experience.
I know,
I'm going to be real.
And
break up.
Oh, so you're trying to tell her to teach the nigga how to improve it.
Well, that's better than...
I think that's step one.
Nah, that might be... It's either that or...
Step one, if niggas will listen to women, though. Niggas don't
listen. Niggas aren't willing to listen, though. Women
it's
are
like if
to
he,
niggas
if,
get
if,
bruised
if it's truly
sorry,
love like how you're talking about, right?
Yeah.
Then I guess he will listen. Or was it love?
Well, hear this.
After 5 years, yeah.
Yeah, no, I ain't got no force on that.
The only problem I have here is that she didn't have the conversation. And
the only reason
she didn't have the conversation is because she's scared.
Yeah, of course. Of course. But we can move on from that. Okay. I can't convince you niggas to let other niggas to fuck you.
Convince me. That's wow.
Yeah, that's crazy.
That's convince. Like, that's a badge of honor to let... You know what's mad? Who's that Donnie that was on Off The Record podcast and he said he'll let Drake fuck his bitch, fam?
Like, oh my God, I know who you're talking
bro,
about.
That's fucking black. And it's a badge of honor.
No, because you were saying, like, you know when you have the conversation.
But who said that?
You know how some people have the conversation in relationships, like, who's your free pass? Like,
or like
celebrity,
celebrity
free
pass.
Pass. Yeah.
Nah, I hate that conversation.
If I have the chance to beat Rihanna, I'm taking it.
Oh yeah, I am. I'm not telling my girl, if Drake is there in the same room, you can go.
Nah, but
no
way, my man
was crazy.
He was excited. He was like, yeah.
I know, but that's a fanboy. He's a fanboy.
Drake, huh?
That's a fanboy.
That's
thing.
An idiot, fam.
Yeah.
But we say
call
that.
Whatever you want.
We say
name,
that, but even
yeah,
a lot of
fanboy.
Famous niggas get that off where they beat the same girls.
That's true. That's like, a very
wait,
good
say
point.
That again.
Even a lot of famous niggas get that off where they beat the same girls and just pass around the same like four women.
Yeah,
same
but thing. Like the fact that you're saying yeah, like I would be honored if Drake fucks my bitch. Like that shit there.
That's weird.
That's why
I
you
would
don't
be
look
honored.
Like,
that's a
word. Bro, that came out of the block, bro. I said,
that's what he said.
Yo.
That's what he said. He said
yes. He's like, it's Drake, man. Everyone's like, yo.
No, I would be honored.
This
crazy.
Jesus Christ.
I would be honored. This crazy.
That's like, that almost sounds like you want to fuck that nigga.
Yeah. That's what it sounds like. Nah, let's, don't shower. Come straight. Like,
nah, let's not lie. Fam. If it was.
What'd you say, Legacy?
Don't shower. Like, come straight. Like, I'm trying to.
That's wild. To
that's
actually get
crazy.
One to shower after yeah, you fuck
Drake.
That is wild.
Now, nah, let's be honest. If it was Jesus, you're probably alive, fam.
Nah, I'm not allowing
that.
I got one then.
Yeah. If Jesus says, for you to get to heaven, I have to fuck your thing.
I said, I always preferred the summer to winter anyway.
Yeah. Martin, Jesus is
yeah, I'll tell Jesus to give me the directions to hell, bro.
Bro.
Where is it? Is it left or right? Where are we going?
Bro.
Hey. Come on.
That is... Yeah.
And I'll tell him, you need to come with me for that. For what you just...
I need 5 minutes, Jesus.
For what you just said. That's crazy. Like, I'm about to tell God what you just said. That's wild.
I know, but... Hey,
man. But, all right. When... Have you not ever been dating a girl, yeah? Because every man in here has had a thing that you've been speaking to for a while. Mm-hmm. And then they've met your family, right?
Not met my family, but...
Well, you've never had a girl meet your family?
No.
Like, ever?
None.
Damn.
No, nah. I have.
Hey, no, I'm going to be real. Look, yeah, because the closest that even happened was I must have been FaceTiming one. And hell... My mom walked in and she waved. Not even like that, but my mom waved at her, bro, and it was just awkward as hell.
Yeah.
And it was awkward as hell, my boy.
And you know, moms be trying to get in there.
They trying to get
that?
In there.
Yeah,
he's there.
Oh,
and I'm
she's so
pretty.
Wait,
yeah,
the worst one is like, oh, is that Denise? And she's like, mom.
Don't say her name. I haven't been chatting about you to my mom.
Mom, this is.
Oh, my God.
This is Lara, mom. Come on, mom.
Let's not do that.
I'm saying the wrong name as well.
My mom's done that before.
Yikes.
Yes.
So sabotaged.
It didn't. Actually, that's kind of questionable. It didn't make her not come back.
Oh, okay.
Which is questionable when you think about it. How much self-esteem do you have for yourself? She'd be ashamed. But but it almost ruined the pattern. Like calling the girl a wrong name. Like now she's asking her, so who's Denise? Like, I don't know who that is. My mom just makes up names. Like, what are you talking about? But when they meet your family, right? I know you've never had this happen before to you, but you two have, right?
I have.
You had a girl that met your family. When they meet your family, at that point, is it fair for women to... I'm asking this outright because I know how I feel about this already. Is it fair for women for a female to feel like your relationship is now at a level where you have to be exclusive and give her everything because you've taken her around your family?
No, I wouldn't say... Oh, you go first.
No, you go.
I wouldn't say give her everything, but I would say it depends on the individual. Because some guys bring things to the yard. I've seen it. Parents know, but it's kind of like, you know when the Beckys and that, okay, I'll give you one story. Yeah,
go on.
So one of our G's was dealing with this girl, innit? Some Becky thing, yeah? And
I didn't know where this was going, but go on.
It's wild, yeah. And the whole family knew. The whole family was there, just calm, chilling. Yeah, fam. Yeah. And the daughter went upstairs, yeah. And he was sitting downstairs in the sitting room. She came back down with underwear, yeah. And called him to say, come upstairs. Parents are not, they knew, gonna come. The dad hit him if give her an extra one for me.
Wait, what?
Say swear to God. Say swear. He's like,
the dad is wild. The dad is so wilding for me, you know. I'd be like, dad,
gee,
like,
I can call him, and he'll even say, fam. And then he looked at the dad, he's like, okay, wait, what the fuck? But he's like, all right, cool, fam. Done his thing. Afterwards, came back downstairs. The dad's like smiling. He said, so did you give her the extra one? He's like, yeah.
White thing, innit?
Yeah, white thing. Yeah, for sure. So basically, what I'm trying to say is, based on that story, it really just depends.
I hope she didn't hear that.
Huh?
So I hope she didn't hear that.
Who? I don't know her. I know him, but shit.
No, but not even like she'd be offended. This is a white girl we're talking about. She might try to go for the dad, like.
was that like a blood farmer? No, because he's
asking questions. I'm, like, actually, is he your stepdad?
If he's your stepdad, he might have just yeah.
Nah. Well, my man was there fantasizing the whole time. He was hearing, like, you know what I mean?
That's wild, bro. That's
yeah,
I'm not gonna lie. If my dad said that, I look at my dad a bit different. But like
crazy.
Come on, guys.
Just to answer the question quickly.
Yeah,
it does. It depends on the type of family you have and that's the type true. Of individual that you are.
I know,
because off that encounter that he had, it's like
it's whatever.
Or let's say reverse it, that was his family. You know?
Yeah,
it's like, okay, it's not really.
It's not that deep.
It's
yeah.
not that deep. But then, based on how
but to
you
him were, though, it's not that deep.
No, I'm saying to her, man. Like, if he was to flip it now,
yeah.
and that was his, and she was coming to see man, but that's how his family is. Then it's kind of like.
Yeah.
That's true, but I feel like most women, not all, of course, whenever I say these things, it's most. Most women feel like when they're around your family, then that means you put them on a type of pedestal that, you know, compared to the rest of your girls or compared to the rest of the people that you might be talking to. Or she just assumes that you're only talking to her and no one else.
You're not wrong, innit? But that's why I said it's based on the vibe that you give off.
Yeah, it does.
Because if your vibe is like, hey, no one's meeting my march, like, nah, you see my mum, like, da-da-da. If your vibe is like, oh, I don't care, anyone can meet my yard. This is where I live, fam. If my marge is in, yeah, we're still doing our thing.
And that's what I'm saying. When I was younger, obviously still living with my parents, I'd bring girls home,
yeah,
not thinking too much of it. Mm. Do you get what I'm saying? Yeah. Like, just being like, this is where I live. This is, my bed is right here. I'm trying to jeet. Like, what else am I going to take you to? I'm not trying to pay for a hotel.
Yeah.
Do you know what I'm saying? But because I've taken them to my house and they've seen my mom spoken to them, they've seen my little brother, they've had an interaction, whatever, now they feel like, oh, we're about to be in a relationship. And then when it's not like that, then he's like, but why did you take me around your family? And all of this shit. And it's like,
no, I get where you're coming from.
That's such an unfair expectation off of me just taking you around my family. And this is not just me saying this. A lot of women believe in this.
No, you're not wrong, innit?
Mm.
I don't know, I just say.
But how do you feel about that?
For me personally, 50-50. It's based off our conversations.
Yeah.
If it's just me, personally, I feel like if I take a woman around my family,
yeah,
it is like, oh, this is my girl, or to present her to like my family, you know?
Mm-hmm.
It depends how horny I am, though.
Exactly, and that's what I was going to get to next.
But if it's solely her, like, oh, I know she values this.
You really think niggas really be thinking about all of this very meticulously, like, ooh, when is she going to meet my family? No, you just meet them when it happens.
I'm saying that, though. I'm saying that that's if I value it and she doesn't really hold a value to it. Okay. If she holds a value to it, I'll never do that.
I'm not going to lie. I take back everything I said because I was looking at it from a point where you live with your mum type shit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But you're saying if I take someone to meet my marge.
Yeah. Like, I'm not saying it like that.
If I live with my marge and then... Like, yeah, it's not a big deal.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. You're right in what I'm saying. If you, like, say for even if you don't live with your family, say for example, I don't know, like you was chilling with her, and then in the middle of chilling with her, God forbid, something happened, and it's a family emergency. And no, you're still
different.
Together.
That's different.
But
that's
then,
different.
Exactly, and you meet by mistake. But some women don't think it's different. Some women are like, he would have told me to go home if he didn't want me to meet his family.
No, that one, I'll conk your head.
See, that's what I'm talking about. Say you specifically said, oh, let's go have dinner with my parents. I want them to meet you and get to know
you. Oh, yeah. That's serious.
Exactly.
That's serious thing.
But women be taking, you just fucking take it. You just, oh, I need to stop here real quick. And your sister pops out to the car like, oh, yeah, is that the new girl that he's dating? Oh, I met his sister now. We're serious.
If I don't live with my family, then I understand that. But if I live in the household, then, I don't see how you, like, it shouldn't be... It really shouldn't be at that thing where you're getting all bubbly.
But some women are, they're just different.
So how do you, you have to meet them. If I live in the same household, you have to see face, fam. Exactly. That's impossible not to see face, fam. You know what I mean?
Exactly. But anyway, we can move on from this topic because I feel like we can have a whole 2 years.
We can talk about this for ages.
Exactly. I was watching $1 Million Worth of Game, the podcast. And I'm sure everyone here knows what that is.
Nah.
I am the real man. Really? I ain't heard of that before.
Oh, shit. It's, you know, Wallow and Gilly? Gilly the Kid?
Nah.
Oh,
who are those people?
Hey, man.
Damn. I thought people knew about it like that, you know?
I'm in tune, but I'm really not in tune. Like fam.
Legacy, you know about them?
Yeah.
So basically, this Gilly used to be a rapper in the 90s. And Wallow is his cousin, went to prison for 20 years or whatever. That's his whole story. But they have a podcast together and they interview, they chill with rappers or entertainers, footballers, basketball players, whatever. And their shit be really interesting because they just be saying some real shit sometimes. But anyways, this week or last week, whenever the fuck it was, Bobby Shmurda appeared on their show. And
oh, well done.
The way this man was throwing his hips around on the couch with
Gilly
the Kid.
Oh, you're talking about that clip? Yeah. Oh, see, yeah, okay.
It was crazy. And I don't really want to get too much into it, but I just mentioned that to say, anyways, when I get to it, you kind of understand why I brought it up. But anyways, that happened. I watched it, but I watched it like halfway through because they wasn't really talking about nothing. It was just all like dramatics. So I turned it off. And then I saw that video was trending. So I paid a bit more attention. And then they had a Clubhouse meeting with Joe Budden,
WAC 100,
yeah. And there was someone else there. I think Academics might have been there.
It wasn't Academics.
But there was someone else, but I can't remember who it was. But anyways, they had the Clubhouse conversation, right?
Yeah.
And Wallow said that back in the day when him and Gilly was hustling, and they normally say this in the podcast anyways, they used to be strippers. Wallow and Gilly, these guys are
the host
of the podcast. They used to be strippers. They used to be male strippers. For women, though. Not for men, but for women. But obviously, you probably get some gay guys coming there a few times because it's open to the public.
Yeah, of course.
But anyways, they used to be strippers, and his stripper name was Throw That Dick.
His stripper name was Throw That Dick?
Yeah, that is
crazy. He named himself? Or somebody named him?
That's the name he came up with.
I'm pretty sure he named
him. Yo, that's crazy.
I don't know.
Throw That Dick.
I don't know who named him, but I'm pretty sure he named himself. But anyways,
Joe Budden.
But I thought like there was one more person. But
yeah, WAC, Joe Budden.
WAC 100, Joe Budden.
Gilly or what?
Gilly the Kid, Wallow obviously was there. But there was someone else that kept making jokes. But anyways, so everyone was clowning him about this, right? And then his response was this. Nigga, back in the day when we was fucked up and broke, we had to hustle and get money out every way possible. Every way possible. By any means possible. Michael Mex for the polls. That type of shit.
He has to be capping.
No, he's not. Apparently there was actually strippers back in the day. Gilly jumped in and was like, yeah, there were strippers, was getting that money. Like, I was dancing for women, blah, 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 blah. Because obviously they was trying to clown him about the whole Burbish murder thing and why you niggas doing that. And I was like, nigga, we used to fucking strip back in the day. That's our lane. That's our thing. So, that's a bit nuts. But why do we look at it like that, though? That's my question. Why do we look at it like that? Because it's a man. If it was a woman.
I look at it both ways.
I know, but there wasn't stripping for men. There was stripping for women. There wasn't stripping for you niggas. Yeah. There was stripping for women.
Yeah. Okay.
Women like that. Like, so what's wrong with a man stripping for women?
Same reason why it's wrong for women to strip.
I know, but niggas don't think it's wrong, though. That's my point.
Yeah, I don't. I mean, shit, yeah.
You're still selling your body.
If I got money.
It's
can
weird,
I not purchase?
Man. It's just weird. It was designed for the woman to be the dancer and do that shit, not for a man, fam. If they made it like it was men.
Oh, no, you're talking about something different.
No, I'm talking
about the whole idea of stripping is weird, anyways. Oh, but you're saying it's weird for a man to do it, but it's okay for a woman to do it.
Yeah, because it's like, it's like when the market for it is strip club. When you think of strip club, you think of females. You don't think of guys. So it's like, yo, that's a weird one still. It's not a unisex. It doesn't give no unisex vibe, fam.
Oh no, it doesn't.
It definitely doesn't.
But obviously, there are women that are into watching men dance.
100% in it.
In my opinion. But if that's their thing and they enjoy it, who are we to like be like, oh, niggas can't take that hustle and make money from that?
I never said that.
That's my point.
I'm just saying.
Based on the whole thing is wrong.
Yeah, get me wrong. The whole thing's wrong.
It just takes a certain caliber of person to do something like that. And
it definitely does.
And I'm just definitely. Hey, man, if that's what you want to do, cool. I'm not going to. I would have a lot of respect for someone if he decided to strip. That's just how it's going to go. But like, hell, that's what you decided.
What did you say?
I have a lot of respect for someone if they've decided to strip.
You said a lot of respect.
Lower.
Emphasize on the lower.
Lower.
Yeah.
But guess we have lower respect for black women, though.
Hmm?
We never. Well, yeah, Bobby Smurda. Yeah.
No, not Bobby Smurda. But we can move on from that. We've all seen Legacy. You want to play the clip?
But what's the full context of it? Because it's a clip.
I'll I'll reveal the full context after we watch the clip.
That you warn guys about girls like me, so tell me about girls like me.
Oh, no, no, let's
just humor in general. No, no, like,
no, no,
I mean,
they start with the Knight Rider thing, no? You don't have that one.
You want me to go? That was like 2 weeks ago.
Oh, okay, no, okay. Start.
No,
no,
don't.
No, no, don't play this yet. Let's start with the Knight Rider thing. Basically, in the video, keep this queued up though, because we're going to get to this soon. Basically, in the video, Asian Doll, who's a rapper, was supposed to be on the podcast. She comes in a bit late. Not a bit, actually. I think she was like an hour late. So she was mad late. She comes in, but she apologizes for being late.
Okay.
And sits down, and they're about to get the podcast going, right? But she's saying something, or she's trying to say something, and the host is telling her to be quiet. And then she's like, that's mean. Like, you're being mean. Why are you being mean? Blah, blah, blah. Because I actually watched the episode, didn't I? And then he's like, no, I'm not being mean. And he goes off on her, like, and but basically he was just mad that she turned up late, basically. Because he was going off of her, going off on her. And the only thing that he was saying was just like, oh, you turn up late and then now you're just fucking talking. And it's like, but she's a guest on the podcast. She's supposed to be here to talk. That's the part. That's like, the part that I didn't feel him on.
I think
like,
I've seen that clip.
I feel like I've seen the clip. To be fair, though, on the clip, I feel like she was talking to her friend that had nothing to do with them.
With
top
the
of
yeah.
Hand. Yeah, and that's what I feel like.
I was with him.
Yeah, I agree with, like, rude. If you're on the podcast, right, and we're all talking.
Not really. Like, I disagree. Do you know why? Yeah. Because of the way the podcast is set up. Bare other people in that podcast do the same thing.
No, that's not the problem. That's
they
not the
do,
issue.
Bro. Bare other girls on there in the sideline talking to each other.
No, but that's not how it's set up. That's not how it's set up. They have the main people that are there, and she was invited, and normally she would sit, like, at the end of the table, and it would be centered around her. But she was late. And they said, okay, we're in the middle of the show because it's live. They do it live.
Yeah.
We're in the middle of the show. Once we pass these couple segments, we'll tap
we'll
you
come
in.
Back to you. Yeah.
But she kept talking on the sidelines. And from what I heard, he had told her multiple times, like, oh, they can hear you on the thing. Nicely as well.
And
they
she
can hear
listen.
You on the thing. And she kept doing it. And that's when he did the extra shit.
I know, but does that mean that he's got to be that rude?
Well, I don't think he was rude.
I feel like if you pull up late...
But in that situation, that's not what I'm talking about. After she left...
Oh, that's... Yeah, it's after the fact.
After the fact, she left. So she leaves now. Because they get into an argument and she's like, I'm not gonna stay here. You're going to talk to me like that. So she leaves. And after she leaves with her friend, then they start sniggering between each other.
Oh, okay.
And like going, oh, we're never going to date a girl that dark anyways. We don't do Knight Riders. And start mentioning all these racial slurs.
Yeah, that's a bit mad.
I saw a video.
That's why I'm not with him, man.
Nah, you see that? I saw a video.
It felt a little bit.
Hey, yo. No, hear this.
Spicy.
You see that video that you're talking about?
Yeah.
Yeah. I remember because academics were speaking about that video that you're talking about they not. It's two separate videos. That was from a year before.
Which video?
The Knight Rider comment. It's not linked.
It's the same video, bro. It's the same video. Bro, I watched the thing. I watched when she... Literally, as soon as she left, they started to call her a Knight Rider. It was in the same video.
Swear. Oh,
yeah,
shit.
I think I have the video. Wait, let me play this.
Which are traits of feminine women? What's her gram?
What's your Instagram?
Dude,
again?
You got like a lot of love today.
Yeah, that's crazy.
I ain't gonna lie. Just keeping it real. I don't really date black girls. It's not because like no. Most black girls are like annoying. How to put this? Ratchet, and they don't know how to like.
But
it's the
same session.
You're
same
like
session.
The complete opposite.
You are not the stereotype. You are not the stereotype.
You are not the same. That's awesome.
So yeah.
So
we'll give you that.
Yeah,
that's
so
mad.
That's mad. Like,
what about the black dating app called Black?
Hatred towards blackness.
It's funny I never used that one, bro. But hey, man.
I mean, hey, bro. If you want to date a bunch of Shaniquas, go for it, man.
I don't fuck with them, to be real.
Me and Fresh aren't really down with LeBron like that. We ain't Knight Riders. So
and you're like, okay, you're being
you know, sometimes if they're you know red bone,
you go off because you know you've been. And now you're disrespecting the podcast. I understand to that point. When she leaves and they start doing this, that's mad.
Exactly.
I like, bro, pattern up now.
No, I agree with you. I agree with you.
DeAndre's right. This isn't after. Exactly. It just went viral after.
Oh.
What do you mean?
So this happened.
This happened separately, and then
in the year
went viral.
And then it went viral after that.
Okay, but still though.
Even so, I can't agree with imagine being black yourself and putting down black women.
Yeah, I think that's
that
a bit
is
crazy.
Mad.
Mm-mm.
But in terms of the Asian door situation, this has nothing to do
with
that.
But then this is why I fuck with Charleston White. You know about Charleston White? In a sense. Yeah. Because it's like, this is where selective politicking comes into play. Yeah. Because it's like, we say we can't, I don't fuck with it because they're disrespecting black women, but, you know, niggas talk about, huh?
It's not just because of disrespect.
But niggas talk about in music. Racist. Niggas talk about in music. Oh, fuck that.
I know, but niggas aren't being racist in music.
Huh?
There's a difference. There's a difference between disrespecting a woman, a black woman, and just being racist. They were just being racist.
True.
They wasn't trying to disrespect her because she's a woman. They was trying to disrespect her because she was black.
She's a dark skinned woman.
Yeah.
Which is why.
True. And that's a fucking issue. And I'm not saying you should disrespect. Exactly. I'm not saying you should disrespect the woman anyway. I'm just saying this is a racism situation. This is not no. That's what. But anyways, play the Britney video.
I get where you're coming from. You're right.
That you warn guys about girls like me, so tell me about girls like me.
Just humor women me. In general. Like, I mean,
well, no, but no, don't women in general, because you literally specifically said before we got on here that you did say that
that's true.
You warn guys about girls like me. So now that we're face to face,
who's girls like me?
What kind of girl am I?
You're not special. You're like other girls. That's the
I'm key. Not special.
Like,
so,
you're like other women that are.
So
like,
what makes you special then?
I never said I was.
What do you gain from telling girls that they're not special? How does that make you feel?
How does that make you feel, that question?
I mean, I know everything is a joke, but I'm asking you a real question. So how does it make you feel? Because if I say you're a bitch ass nigga, that does something for me, right? If I insult you or if I tell you you're not special, you're forgettable. On, what does that do for me? No, but that doesn't, but that's what I'm saying. No, but I'm saying, what if I call you, if I just say that, again, you're forgettable. That's why I didn't want to do you guys' podcast. Forgettable. Hate the setup. The name is underwhelming. I didn't really see the value in it. Mm. Right? No, that's how I feel. Right. But, right. So...
It works, though, because it's so odd.
It is. That's true. And also, the reason why they're popular is because of academics.
Mm. Yeah.
That nigga needs to... You need to be careful what he makes popular. But, anyways... Going back to this conversation, though, what did you want to talk about with the Britney Renner situation? I'll let you lead this.
Me?
Yeah, go on. Your time to shine.
Me personally, like, if you're tuned in,
mm-hmm.
I like that.
So you listen to them?
If you're tuned. No, I have friends that listen to them.
Oh, so but you have friends that listen to people that are racist to black women?
Can I finish?
That's crazy. I'm playing.
If you listen to them, it's like, it's a whole community. They're part of the Red Pill community. And there's a couple creators over the last...
Can you explain the Red Pill community?
It's like dating coaches.
I'll take over. Red Pill community is beta males on steroids.
Oh,
simple like that.
It's the niggas that say they're alpha males,
but they're not,
and they're beta males on steroids.
They're trying to show you how to get girls. They're saying this and that.
It's so stupid.
Have you seen the video of the guy that's like doing a tutorial and how to? Oh, this is how you walk up to a girl, randomly at any time, and then he walks up to the guy and he's like, It was so embarrassing. It was so funny.
Yeah, see, like, that's embarrassing, man.
That's what I'm saying, bro. It's this red pill, blue pill shit. It's just so
nigga has no game. But if you cut the video off after he was like, oh, let me show you how. You would have thought he was the most fly nigga ever. Like,
and then you gonna pull up on fumble.
There are a couple, like, they refer to it as the manosphere, where it's like,
wait, what?
The manosphere, where it's like,
oh my gosh,
it's
crazy.
It's a lot of self-help.
I thought that's doing more harm than help.
That's a scam.
Like gurus, like a lot of that.
Yo,
manosphere.
No, you're laughing, yeah, but a lot of the actual content creators,
yeah,
are like proper. They do it. They're not like, this is how you get women, and a lot of them are like. Kevin Samuels would be in the manosphere, but he's an image consultant.
Can we just say that he's an advisor?
All these
terminologies.
That's just what it is.
I said manosphere.
That's just
like,
what it is.
That just sounds like a place I do not want
to
be.
Oh my lord, I'm not trying to be in manosphere, my boy.
It's just a particular niche in the market.
Yeah, it is. It happened around manosphere, lockdown. It happened around lockdown.
Fair enough.
He comes up with this bullshit.
No, it's been around for ages. It just popped off.
Popular
it just popped up, so a lot of people are on it.
Still, who came up with this?
I don't know. You think red pill is bad? There's black pill as well.
Oh, wow.
Black
pill.
Let's black not pill. Get into black that Black pill yet. Is not hating women. They hate women.
Oh, whoa.
They hate women. No, black pill, they hate women.
All right.
You know what I heard is...
But carry on with this. So let's not get sidetracked.
Okay.
Carry on with
okay,
this.
Okay.
So we all know Brittany Renner. She's like the model girl for...
Scammer.
Scammers. Whores.
For getting nigga baby.
Baby moms. Yeah. She's like the poster girl for that.
If I didn't take the red pill the next day, no, is it red pill? Birth control pill the next day was a person, it'll be Brittany Renner.
Mud.
No offense.
But yeah, she went on Academics podcast with the Fresh and Fit guys.
Uh-huh.
And she basically had, in the clip, she had a lot to say. But I heard that in the actual thing, she didn't really have.
Yeah, natural thing. She didn't. Yeah, no.
Because I didn't watch the full video.
They spoke about her and PJ Washington type shit. It was kind of like a back and forth. Like, but it was just more so of a conversation.
Okay.
Where she's taking in their point, their perspectives, trying to relate to, like, assess her situation and then give a reasonable response. It wasn't the same energy as that clip.
Obviously, yeah. They're going to use the clip to
advertise. For sure. Like, in that clip where she gave them smoke, I ain't even going to lie, fam.
Yeah, that was mad.
She did. And they, I mean, to be honest with you, for me, like, this is divisive as fuck. Because I don't even agree with either one of them.
Yeah, both of them are in their own.
But exactly, do you know what I mean? Like, it's like, you're both just fucked on different...
Spectrums.
Literally.
Who? Fresh and Fit and
both of them are wrong in like different aspects.
Both of you are wrongins. You're all wrongins, basically. So. And that's why sometimes I look at Academics a bit sideways. Cause I fuck with what Academics is built. Like, maybe not how we built it. I already know but I fuck with how we built it, but I fucked with what he's built.
Mm.
And I kind of respect it because obviously you don't get to numbers like that without putting in hard work for years on end.
Yeah.
So for that alone, I respect it. But sometimes some of the people that he be associating himself with is just a little bit skeptical.
But here it is.
Personally,
he's not a role model, fam. That's not the way. He's
that's
like, true. I'm an individual. Yes,
I know, but that's true. And I'm not saying that he's my role model because he's definitely
not
my role model.
That's a strong.
But what I am saying is, when I pay attention to someone's content or I try to learn, because me personally, whenever I'm doing all this shit that I'm doing, I'm learning from people that I see on the internet, you know?
Yeah.
And I'm trying to get game from this shit that they've done or whatever they do, if they say a story about some mistake that they made or just watching their show and seeing how they set it up and how it's like, sort of like, what's the word I'm looking for? Executed and shit like that. So, with Academics, he was one of those people that I used to look to for that. But some of the shit that he'd be doing... it's questionable to me, and it's not what I would want to represent my brand.
You see,
that makes sense.
I don't know how I feel about that.
Me neither. That's what I'm saying.
Yeah, you see, it's like I started to like go based off like I take the message. I don't give a fuck about the messenger at all because everybody's flawed. If you got a good message, calm. Man doesn't put anybody on pedestals. Like no one can. Do something that is disappoints me.
Because
it's like it is what it is, fam. I don't care, and that's what people have to have, fam. Fresh and Fit, they do very questionable shit, and then they make sense in the same sense. Same as Brittany Renner does a lot of questionable shit, and she will make sense in the same sense. But it's like just take the message, decipher
it, that's true.
And just keep it pushing, man.
That's true. Mm-hmm. That's true.
Don't have attachment to shit.
All right, welcome, ladies and gentlemen, once again to the Podfellas Podcast new music segment. Today is going to be short, quick, snappy. Not going to spend too long on this new music segment. The first record we have lined up is by none other than the UK's best drill rapper.
Oh. Whoa. Let's not do that.
Niggas is hating.
Let's not cap.
Put a pause on that. Legacy, what you had this morning, man?
Bro,
you ate breakfast?
This is what the people are saying.
This is what the people are saying.
What are you saying?
What people?
It came out of your mouth.
Hey, man.
This nigga.
Arguably, debatably,
Answer the date. Okay.
The UK's
definitively.
Who's he? Okay, so who's he competing against?
He's in a close second.
To.
Don't
Scribs.
Oh my god.
Scribs.
That's a punk ass answer.
I would say I'll say Quinn is better than Digga from.
I got Quinn above Digga.
Quinn is definitely better than Digga.
I got Quinn above Digga.
Even Swarms is better than Digga.
Yeah. Swarms is not.
At least
we'll talk about Swarms at some point. Some point.
Yeah, man. I take it that far.
I would even say CB is better. CB is better than Digga D.
Yeah.
I'm doing too much.
Let's just play it. This is a 50 Cent sample, actually. Uh-huh. So I'll ask around the room after we play it if anybody recognizes the sample.
Okay.
This is Pump 101 by Digga D and Still Brickin'. Pause.
Hey, I understand why, man. It's alright, it's alright. Yeah, that's a crazy name.
What does that mean?
I don't know, man.
Come on! With four chains swinging. One shot out the clock, leave your head back spilling. Emerald cut diamonds, say I'm Pyrex living. How can I say this in a friendly way? Before we fuck, babe, I beg you sign this NDA. Take you shopping, what Louis or the Fendi way? And we can stay on Park Lane, not in MPK. She wanna snap in. Sorry, this nigga just said, before we fuck, I bet you sign an NDA. Nigga, you release your own sex tapes, bro.
Whoa.
Like,
whoa.
What? Anyways. Whoa. Yeah, but I ain't moving the whip. Just run downstairs for another cough quick. Mayfair hotel, I know you're loving this shit. Make sure this best spit when you're sucking this. As long as I'm living this high life, still roll around in uptown with my knife. Burger King, cause man, not near five guys. Grandpa, I fill up with some nine. I'll load at the pump, my guns are stocked up. Got grown and glocked up in a stolen Benz. I'll load at the pump, my ops are sneaky and we can't get you. So we soaked his friends. I'll load at the pump, my lines stay ringing, my guys stay chinging. What's the problem, fam? I'll load at the pump, every op left bleeding. So they started teaming, cause we smoked their gang. I'll load at the pump. Pesky told me, wake up to reality. He can't lie, I was sitting there mad at him. Okay. And that's the end of that track. We know the traffic and I know it's embarrassing trying to get shit across the border. Hella, you saw taking man's orders. Look, man, orders.
I'm sorry, but I ain't got nothing against girls because some of them are hard, yeah.
Some of them are, but their acting is funny as fuck. Sorry, no offense. I mean, respectfully.
No, man, respectfully. Bro, you meant order disrespect.
What? I should have nigga say respectfully. Disrespect is coming. Yeah. I was just about to look at this. This is a classic song. Come on, come on. Nigga did not do it justice.
Yeah, he didn't, but like, it was alright.
It wasn't as bad, you're right. Yeah, it was not as bad as I thought it was going to be. But.
Did you play the original?
Yeah. Oh. The original sounded way better.
Yeah, of course.
Of course.
Yeah. I know, but then that's the thing. If you're gonna take a fucking sample and remix it, how's it sounding worse than the original? Nah, they already did the work.
I gotta say though, like if you gonna put like a Liverpool, you can't put some brother no one's ever heard of that stuff. You gotta put like actual good scouts or like Cast or something. Exactly. Like, that brother was that.
Or someone that could actually rhyme with that beat. Like that guy was not on beat at all.
Because that's the thing, innit? Because the accent puts him off beat. That ain't not in him. That's just how it is. Like
that's true, but you can find there's certain beats that fits their accent.
Yeah, I know.
Like but, I don't know that TikTok song that's been going around with the Scouse rapper. I don't know if you have heard it.
Oh, the Hazy brother.
No, I think it might be that one.
Yeah, that's Hazy. Yeah, that's Hazy.
Yeah, like that guy, for example, that sounds hard. Exactly, and that's my point. But anyways, carry on.
For those of you here that don't know, that sample was from G Unit's Stunt 101.
This guy's such a music nerd.
I have to say that.
That was from G Unit's Stunt 101. I said this last week, right? And I think I finally decided that I'm just not gonna listen to UK rap this year at all.
Oh, really? Me too. Because well, not UK rap for me, UK drill.
I noticed that like in this end of like November, December-ish, the trend was hopping on like classics and slapping it on a drill beat, and then just.
You know what? No, I can agree with that. Wait.
So the trend is like you take a song that banged back in the day. You slap it on a drill beat, and then
is that what they're doing here?
Yeah, that's the trend now.
New York.
Yeah, that's the trend now.
That's New York's thing, fam.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I've heard.
But they're not even sampling. That's the thing.
Yeah, they're just taking it off. And they're literally just raising the, like, the BPM so it's like they can rap on the drill type flow. It's mad.
So they're not even making anything new.
That thing is just sounds
they're
horrible,
using the
fam.
Same flow as the original song. Some of them are using the same hook. It's they're just making parody records, basically.
Basically.
Yeah, no.
Like, what's the... I think when Millions made, like, Bandol Sport, I was...
Bandol Sport was...
I was disappointed.
It was underwhelming, yeah.
It was very
it just felt too parody.
Especially from a guy like Millions. Yeah, like, I have so much respect for Millions.
It's the same guy that made, like, when he made Billions, I was like, oh, this is hard.
Exactly.
You know, like, then, even, like Teacher's Own, Lago, some people liked it. I was more like... But it's like, the fact is, like, you're at this level.
You're better than this.
You're better than this, is what I'm trying to say. So it's like, yeah, that annoyed me still.
What was the one that was popular on TikTok? Like, it was like, sometimes I look up to the sky, I wonder why I lost a couple members. Have you heard that
one? You know what? I ain't heard it start to finish, but I keep hearing it here and there.
I didn't even know that.
That's the one that started it for me.
Well, someone took that and drilled it.
Yeah.
Oh my
God. That's dead.
That was the first one.
Disappointed.
Very disappointed.
In fact, your boy, what's his name? Your boy, Swarms.
Don't call him my boy. Don't do that.
Has kicked off.
Wait, hold on.
That's your boy.
Well, he is better than Digga D. He is, but he's not my boy. That guy is terrible, man.
Has taken an absolute classic. Listen to this.
Oh my God.
Oh
no.
God.
Who can do the dance?
Don't tell me he's gonna make this drill music. Oh my God.
You done this?
I take that back.
Yeah,
Diggity's back.
Yeah, Diggity.
Yeah,
at least Diggity wouldn't do that.
I swear pounds do change on me. Moves like the shade, I'm a crewmate Sully. When it's on top, boy, we had to move straight rally. And long time ago. Like, I hope you got my money with that. Yeah, it's funny, to the front door, come off the latch. Took the U-turn and then we spun it right back. Funny how we coloured, but we covered in black. Baby, it's all covered. Smooth, yet I'm all so rugged. 20 seconds to go, so solid. Or was it 21? Forgive me, I was young. I was 12, making rhythms while they twiddling their thumbs. Who in their right mind to leave the biscuit for the crumbs? Business in the slums, niggas fiddling the funds. But I multiply, then I triple up the sum. I told them, are you finished or you done? Dickhead. Payback, the big payback. Dark on both sides, the dress code black. Count my money up, I need my racks. Selling a dream, but I'ma need that back. Nah, I can't wait for his album. The album's good. My money up, I need my racks. Yeah, selling a dream, but I'ma need that back.
Speak a money language, can't spot the accent. Poetry in motion, my pen look like a Mac 10. Move it like a 1010, prove it like I'm tinting. Wrap my freedom like a gift and I ain't seen a trap since. Long day, no sleep, I was doing mad trips. Mind doing back flips, creasing the stanceless. Plenty of a fish in the sea, but they catfish. Not even in the bank we trust, it's in a mattress. Walk up in the office like you know me now.
Yeah, shout out to Koji Radical.
Mm-hmm.
That was
Payback by Koji Radical featuring Nux. Produced by Cameron Palmer.
Cameron, shout out to you, Cameron Palmer.
Cameron Palmer.
Yeah, man.
That was dope.
That was a hard song.
Mm-hmm.
Straight to the next one?
Yeah, might as well. Yeah. I feel like, let's play the music and then we should talk about lyrics being used in court. Because it's perfect.
That's perfect.
Yeah.
Alright, the next record, we're going to fly all the way to Africa.
Ooh, okay, my guy, okay. This song is so hard. Let's go. This is another album I'm waiting for.
Yeah, I'm waiting for this one.
Ooh, this song about to be lit. Ooh.
This is Adekunle Gold. Mercy.
Let's go. It's your baby, got it, body, body, oh, this song is so hard. Even fucking Joe Budden had to play it on this podcast. Yeah. Open my eyes, show me who they and Joe Budden don't really play Afrobeats like that. It's more like R&B. Make a no tip up rose with my enemy. Oh, that part is so hard. Scatter them. I don't know if you guys understand broken English, like African broken English.
Help
away the disguise. Basically, it says make a no pop rose with my enemy. I pray that I don't ever pop rose with my enemy. They try to mandate. that's a hard bar, because some niggas be just guys as your friend, and you find out they're anyway down the road, and you're like, damn, fucking celebrating you, in there, like the whole time you hate him. When I show, make way when I show. In the grey set, I go the boss. I go the dengue, I go the boss. Then go walk up to the girl when I show. In the make way when I show. In the grey set, I go the boss. I go the dengue, I go the boss. Then go walk up to the girl. As you can see, I'm just beginning. And I trouble nobody. So make nobody bother me. As you see me, I got the fight for me.
And that was Mercy by Adekunle Gold. And that one was produced by...
Hey, that's crazy.
No, try. Attempt.
I'm going to go with Belize Beats.
Oh.
I think it's Belize. So I'm going with Belize.
Belize Beats.
Belize Beats.
Okay.
Belize Beats.
Okay. All right. Cool.
The next record... The next record,
just play this song,
is
man.
By none other than The Game.
Yeah.
Okay. Featuring Kanye West.
Yeah.
And this is Easy.
He was one sister from around the way.
My life was never easy.
I love this song. But I feel like it's one of those songs where I'm gonna like for a little while, and then after a while I'm gonna be annoyed hearing it.
Yeah, right.
Started in my cutlass clutching heat like it's an open oven. Puffing chronic, puffing Biggie out the window, speaker subbing. Running to the crypts, it ain't no discussion. Bullet wounds drenched in Hennessy and teaspoons of Robitussin. Head up phase, got a few concussion. Yeah, Compton's a maze, Dr. Dre percussion. God, please grant my nigga eternal life. We need the beats. Aftermath where you fall asleep, you do not eat. And my belly is full. Gorilla riding the bull, banana clips in the pool. Swan diving, classy azure. The ops, I'm on they ass. Grandmama whoopings in school. This Wilmington in Brazil where niggas die in they jewels. Too many problems, too many YGs. So many ties to dollar signs, easy to end up on E. I got shot up like Columbine, the Crips descended on me. Signed my name on the dotted line, that was vengeance on beats. This is the way.
He was one sister from around the way.
My life was never
easy.
Oh. My life was never easy. YG the rapper,
yeah,
and young. I think YG the rapper, but I'm like, don't interrupt, just because, no love, show the shrug, could be right, that's what I thought as well, but then I was like, I ain't bring nothing to the table, I'ma turn up the music,
wake up the neighbors, I'ma get that thug life tatted across the navel, it's how I am in real life, not just on cable, Mr. Narcissist, tell me about my arrogance. No more counseling. I don't negotiate with therapists. God, yeah. Wanna let God in. But tonight, I guess
Kanye West thinks therapy is negotiation. That's narcissism right there. There's no negotiation, bro. Like, well, some of your traits are toxic for me.
I cameras watch the kids, I stopped taking the credit. Not custodial dad, I bought the house next door. What you think the point of really being rich for? When you give them everything, they only want more. Bougie and a ruler, y'all need to do some chores. Rich ass kids, this ain't your mama house. Climb on your brother's shoulders, get that top ramen out. God sent me from that crash, just so I could beat Pete Davidson's ass. And my new bitch bad.
And I knew him, not me mad. Illuminati mad. Nah, that's so
good. That Pete Davidson's ass.
Yeah, I've been listening to that all week.
Yeah.
I just had to, like, I
do like how Kanye talks about things that are presently happening.
Same. It's very refreshing. And also, as well, the new Nas album that I listened to, he's doing the same thing on that as well. It's very refreshing.
I listened to Nas' album.
It's hard, right?
Fire.
Hard.
Every song on there.
I was so happy because Nas is my favorite rapper of all time, in my opinion.
No, Nas is dope still. Like, every once in a while, I still got to go on Illmatic, bro. Every once in a
while. What? Like, you can't not. Yeah. He's the only guy that's rapped backwards. He's rapped a story backwards. Like he's described the story happening backwards.
Yeah, that's different.
The song's called Rewind, and no one else in the whole history of hip hop has even attempted to do that.
Because they're gonna do that, they're gonna be dead. They're gonna be like, "Hey man, you try to be
literally."
Lost.
And if they have, ain't nobody heard that shit.
Ain't no one heard that.
Nas is it's good.
They try to hear that, be like, "Hey man, it's trash."
Literally, and that's why I'd be mad when people be talking about Jay-Z, but not put Nas in the same light.
You gotta put Nas there, man.
Because I respect Jay-Z as well, but Nas
Nas is. Gotta be real, like Nas is a better like technical rapper than Jay-Z.
Absolutely,
come on, like
absolutely. Jay-Z just got more swag,
I guess, you know.
Yeah, he does. I mean, because Nas is my favorite rapper, and around the time where the beef was going on, I was a Nas like.
Oh what?
Yeah, I was riding for Nas. I was like, fuck Jay-Z.
I heard that Jay-Z stole a couple of Mandem's bars though.
Jay-Z stole bad man. He stole Nas's bar.
Yeah.
Yeah. He stole it and made it a song, and then he replied to Nas, "You made a hot line, I made a hot song." That's where that famous line is from.
Oh. I heard like my man, like Jay-Z stole songs from.
Oh, well, you just took the song.
Stole people's songs.
Yeah, Kanye West has been on interview saying that.
Oh, I see.
Yeah. Takes people's song. But anyways.
That is the end of our new music segment.
I didn't expect the podcast to get a bit intense like it just did, but I'm glad that it did. Listen, I mean,
2022.
We don't have to go back.
No, 2022. Okay. I'm gonna debate every black topic that comes up. No,
I'm ready for
in my opinion, there's nobody actually talking having the questions like, "Is this the hill we want to die on?" I'm okay with being wrong. I'm fully okay with being convinced. I'm not always gonna be on the side of I don't agree. Sometimes I might just agree. But we need to have the conversation.
Nah, he's right. He's right.
Nah,
that's
a fact. But
he's right. He's right.
Hey man,
he's right.
You're a brave guy, man.
Hey man, we got mad topics we can talk about with that. And you should carry on going with that, like arguing it, because some of the things that we find as just the norm in hip hop or in our culture, or whatever, really is fucked up. Way But anyways, we're not gonna get into that right now. Jake Paul, how you lot feel about the boxing match against Mike Tyson, the Iron Mike himself.
For Mike?
Yeah, no, he's about to fight Mike. He hasn't fought him yet. He's about to.
You might die.
He might. Because, like, did anyone watch the last Mike Tyson fight? It was an exhibition
He was looking young, man.
Yeah, and it was fucking that nigga up. Nigga was like, "Yo, Mike, like, we just play."
His punches are still heavy.
And then Mike don't give a fuck about no exhibition, nothing. That nigga go punch that nigga in the face.
Mike Tyson's gonna close his chest.
But what if they have a... I just realized what you said. That's peak. What if they have a clause in the contract there? That says Mike.
That's why I don't like Jake Paul fights. It's not boxing.
Yeah, because it definitely had a clause in the Floyd fight.
It's like what's his name?
I don't know if you saw that. No,
it's like Dwayne Johnson and Jason Statham contract where they can't lose a fight.
Yeah, literally, like, it's like that. Like the Floyd Mayweather one, because I watched a little bit of it, and after I turned it off because it was obviously fixed. There's so many times that Floyd could have knocked this nigga out.
They're not allowed to knock each other out.
There's so many times Floyd could have just given him
a little boom. There was one point where Floyd was holding him up.
There was one point where he went down and Floyd like helped him up. And I was like, yeah, this is obviously fucking... Yeah,
you know what? Okay. This is my stance on that.
Yeah.
I'm calm with that. Because Mike Tyson... His style is like he goes all out for like the first two halves.
Yeah.
Then he starts the fatigue kicks in and all of that. As long as my man is plummeting my man's face, I'm okay with him not getting knocked out.
Knocked out. So,
I just want it to be very entertaining. But at the same time, it's like
it's gonna be entertaining.
At the same time, it's like
it's Jake Paul.
We're talking about Mike Tyson here. Mm-hmm. I don't think Mike Tyson would agree with that. But then again, I don't know Mike personally, so I can't really say. But
that's true.
What happens if Jake wins?
There ain't no way,
bro. We say no that? Way. What? They, no way.
That? Wait. Take that blasphemy out of your mouth.
Say
bro.
That.
Come on, bro.
You say that?
No.
Mike Tyson's legacy is
done. Done. Bro, that's it. That's the end of Mike Tyson's legacy.
I'm sorry. That's it. Like, bro, there will be so many conspiracies which probably would be correct, but it's all irrelevant.
That's what I'm saying. Is it worth it?
Well, for Mike, it is.
For Mike,
because
yeah.
Mike, it is. It is. Do you know why?
For the opportunity that
because he gets
happen.
To play with his
do you know
team.
Why? Do you know what I say? Basically, it, yeah. That's one reason. Another reason why it's worth it for Mike is the money. Number one, I'm sure I can guarantee you Mike is getting paid more than Jacob is getting paid from this.
Yeah.
Because the reason why people are watching it is because you want to fight me.
Yeah.
I wasn't looking to box you. Do you know what I'm saying? So the money that Mike is going to make from this one fight, I'm sure it's going to be fucking ridiculous. Right? That's number one. And number two, this is Mike Tyson. Exactly. Mike Tyson is not worried in the slightest that he might lose this.
And then hear this, yeah. Let's look at if Drake won, people are going to say, oh, Mike Tyson was old, whoopty whoop, X, Y, Z, but then Jake Paul will say, but you lot say that he's old. But let's look at his movements. Let's look at his hit power. Let's look at all these variables. Yeah, I may not be getting the 18 or whatever year he was boxing. I may not get that, Mike. But this Mike is still a solid thing. Like, he will knock a lot of you professionals out. And guess what? I beat him. I got in a ring with him. Fam. And it's just like... Gee, do you know what happened to boxing?
Like, boxing is already finished when they let these niggas do that.
But is that a good thing? Isn't that a good thing though? I think it's a good thing.
Let's argue.
If you want attention,
this new age found boxing.
If you want attention,
they revived it.
Yeah,
but yeah, I'm saying, so. But they revived it, and if Jake wins, he will finish it.
Oh yeah, yeah, but that's not gonna happen.
Yeah, it's not. So
well, I hope I'm not playing back this tape. I'm like, oh my god, I couldn't
imagine.
Believe it.
Imagine telling this tape that you start from now.
Yeah, in it, no.
That's really lost.
Hey, if Mike Tyson loses, I'm telling my kids Jake Paul was Mike Tyson.
Nah.
And I'm telling them Mike was Jake. I was like, oh, this is nigga Jake here for bare long. People thought no one could ever beat him, and then Mike came in and punched him up. But. It'd be hard describing why Mike was white.
And another and another thing. I don't want to say I'm worried about Mike Tyson. But from the way he's described his boxing career on his pod and in the past and the stories he tells and the difference he says he feels in his personality and the things he's achieved since he left. And he has a slightly bad like recollection of his boxing career and some of the things he did. Don't lose because you're going back there.
Oh yeah, absolutely.
Don't lose because your mental state is going right back there.
Absolutely.
Like,
and first of all, I don't know why you're entertaining this conversation that Mike may lose. But I'll play along. If Mike Tyson ever loses against Jake Paul, no one's ever going to see Mike Tyson the way that they see Mike Tyson. Right.
He's no longer
ever.
My favorite.
Mike Tyson's not, I agree with
that's
DeAndre.
What I'm saying. Mike Tyson's not going to see Mike Tyson.
Yeah, it's over.
Yeah, can't ask me who my favorite boxer is.
He's no longer my favorite boxer, fam.
That's true.
I can no longer say, oh, he will smack up Muhammad Ali. Even though it may be fake, because I already probably know what's happening now, that Jake Paul probably said, yo, I will give you at least like 70% of my pay.
That's why he agreed. To be honest with you, that's the approach that would even make him agree to some shit like this. You get what I'm saying? Because your legacy is already solidified.
That's what I'm
and
saying.
And Mike
as
Tyson
well,
is not in need of money. Like, he's got his podcast going. Like, it's not like he's broke at the minute and he needs money. It's just that they're offering him ridiculous amount of money.
That's what I'm saying as well. I can see Mike being the guy to purposefully lose the match. In fact.
Or just to make more money.
I don't even know if money is the thing that will do it.
I disagree completely.
Do you disagree?
Do you know how much like that will fuck up his brand and his money that he's currently making? Niggas only still listen to Mike Tyson because of the way that we feel about Mike Tyson. That's why his podcast
is
so successful.
That's very true.
Jake Paul comes in and boxes him up. The viewers is going down.
You see it like that. I for some reason I doubt that Mike sees it like that.
Look at it like this as well, yeah. Mike Tyson. Shit, I forgot my point.
Oh, that's crazy.
That's nuts. But okay, cool. We can move on from this anyways, because there's not that much more else to say about it. Unless you've
when is the fight?
I have no idea, but it's soon. I'm not going to be tuning in. I'll probably just watch.
Nah, I'm gonna just check the timeline, see who wins.
Yeah, exactly. That's what I'm gonna do. I'm not tuning in.
Highlights,
That's dead.
I ain't even gonna check the highlights, man. I wanna just see the last hit, bro. He got knocked out.
Words.
Do we know how many
did
rounds?
How did Jake Paul get folded? Really?
Well, how many rounds is?
I bet it's four.
I got three.
No, how many was no in the last one? No more than three rounds. Floyd.
I'm pretty sure it's like six. Or
yeah, probably about the same.
Six, three, six minutes.
It's the same thing. He would
probably want to go long rounds.
That's what I'm saying. If it's a lot of rounds, if they go to the end, it was rigged.
If they go to the end, it was rigged. Definitely. Come on.
That's what I wanted to say quickly. When Mike Tyson fought my man, the other guy, Mike Tyson said, like, I watched the press conference, he's just like, bro, I was just so happy to be out there.
He wasn't putting no effort, and it looks like he was fucking in the ground.
So that's what
I'm saying, he's just happy to be there. He might just lose it, because...
No, he might see it like, oh, no.
I feel like the other thing, it's like, he's just happy to be there. Nah.
He enjoys being hit in the face.
You know what I mean? A nigga that's happy to be in the ring, that says something about your mentality.
Bro, he's a different guy.
Yeah. Bro, I'm scared to be in the ring. Niggas happy to be there.
And it's like, I ain't scared to be there.
I wouldn't be happy. I'll be in a courageous mood. Like,
you're not seeing me doing all of the freaking shadow boxing. No, bro, I'm focused, bro.
From a boxing standpoint, Jake and Mike are like the same height. They've got like the same reach.
Oh, swear. But
nah, I swear Jake has longer arms.
Jake's taller.
No, Logan is the one that's really tall. Jake's like 5 something.
Yeah.
So they're both like the same dude. And
when Mike Tyson closes his chest, so that's when he gets in there. Jake is gonna look over to the corner.
And that doesn't have nothing to do with nothing, anyways. Because Logan, the taller one, fought Floyd, and he should have lost.
Yeah.
I mean, that don't have nothing to do now. That's true. Your height, nothing. Like these are Stone Cold killers that were going against other professional Stone Cold killers.
That's
and
true.
Won
Mike Tyson,
by a mile.
Mike Tyson's got a lot of
that. And that's the thing. People always...
And he's one of the hardest hitters.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. And people always miss... Like, they always get the perception wrong because we've seen them against other professionals. Those other professionals,
that's
don't
true,
get fucked
actually.
Up.
That's
those
very
niggas
true.
Will fuck up Jake Paul. Mm.
Like, that's
you
very
know what I mean?
True.
And they beat those niggas. Come on.
Yeah.
Like this. And that's why I say you even mentioning that Mike may lose is fucking laughable. If Mike ever hears that, like, come on. This guy's funny, man. It's a joker, man. It's a joker. Don't sit and fit like that, man.
One thing about Mike, man, it's like, hey, yo, his whole presence and his voice, they don't
it's
add up, man.
They don't add up.
Fam, if I didn't know Mike could hit the way he could hit, I could see this nigga in the fucking shopping center and disrespect him. Imagine you getting a fight with a nigga like that and you're not
sure.
Does Mike sound similar to Michael, fam? Just a little.
A little bit. But anyways, is there anything else that anyone else wants to say about that?
No, that's it.
I'm just going to run down last two topics and then we're going to close the thing off. We've been here for a while. Thank you very much, guys, for joining this episode of this podcast. It's been amazing.
Yeah.
But Noisy, basically Noisy is this music channel on YouTube.
Oh, I've heard about
which
that.
Which is,
which
is like a subsection of Vice.
Yeah.
Vice TV. They released a 6-7 documentary a couple
Again?
Days ago. Again? They released one before.
Bro, this bear.
Oh.
I swear they've done like two.
It's the first one I've ever seen. But they released one recently.
Oh, actually, it might have been Vice directly that did one.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, this one was Noisy. Mm-hmm. But anyways, this was centered around OD though, because he just got released up.
That's not a 6-7 documentary.
But they put... Actually, no, they didn't
even... Nah, I think they just put OD's
OD,
name.
Yeah,
that's an OD documentary. OD.
Yeah, no, but still, he's 6-7. Like, let's be real. Him and Dimzy are 6-7. But anyways, the documentary was interesting to me because they actually talked about how 6-7 made UK drill like a thing in the UK.
Yeah.
And they did. And they were the one that made it. And I just always felt like niggas on trying to... And to be honest with you, back to the conversation that we were having earlier, if the record labels are coming from America, if they understood the culture of drill music, they would have these niggas everywhere with the artists that they're trying to... fucking market to us as drill artists. They'll have these niggas coaching them people. Like, actually, let me
LD's
stop
not
before.
Doing that.
Pardon?
LD's not.
Yeah, of course, he's not doing that. But let me stop before I give them label people ideas, because they always steal ideas from bad people.
Mm-hmm.
But anyways, like, they should understand I was just happy to see the documentary because they deserve the flowers. They did it when it wasn't like the popular thing to do. They stuck by it, made it famous, even though there was a lot of
controversy. Fuckery, and whatever. And,
do you know what I mean? Yeah. But shout out to them. The island boys.
Oh,
have you seen the video? Go to your DM, Legacy.
Is that the one where they're seeing how it is in jail and
There's these two kids from Miami.
Yeah.
Right, and they wanted to. What's that?
That's mad, right?
Have you seen the video? Play the video.
Women are not good people. That one.
Oh yeah. We'll go and play that one at the end. Play the Island Boy one now.
Is this real? Oh yeah.
The one where she's fucking him up.
She's giving him 20-piece combo.
He's getting a mighty
No way.
Yeah, niggas crying. Yes, niggas crying. So our nigga, the Island Boys. So basically, these niggas went viral because they had a freestyle tap song that they released. Island Boy. And it just sounded funny because it was shit. Mm. So it went viral and, you know, they became popular or whatever. I just saw that video and I thought it was hilarious. But...
Where did he get fucked up?
Yeah, he got fucked up by his girl, innit?
For what?
I don't know. I didn't read too much into the story.
He recorded that his brother.
Really got pissed up by that.
I don't know, actually. Maybe I think she might have recorded it.
Or maybe someone else.
Both her hands were free.
Yo, no need to say that.
You're disrespectful, fam. Man said both her hands was free. Mad thing.
I was free,
but it was. But play the Women Are Evil video and let DeAndre see it. I'll play it over here so this guy can see it as well.
What is it? Is it peak?
It's peak. It's peak, bro. I'm putting loudspeaker as well so these bitches can hear it. It's peak, bro. This will make you not believe in women, actually.
Hey, babe. Just checked in my hotel.
How was your flight?
Longest 7 hours of my life. I'm tired as fuck, bro.
This is a shit.
Jet lag is an understatement.
It's not, it's real.
Get some rest, honey.
Yeah, I'm about to do that.
I'm not going to play the audio because it's going to come.
Hold on. Baby.
They're gonna
baby.
Wait. Mm-hmm.
Baby.
This is the part. Look.
No,
you see
skit.
That nigga?
Yeah.
Because niggas face.
It's a skit.
Niggas like. Yeah. Nah, nigga. Niggas is saying. I checked in the comments. Niggas is saying this is real still. But this is too hard, so you can't believe what you hear.
Yeah, nah. That's definitely skit.
I don't give a fuck. But my question is this: You're on FaceTime with your girl. You're saying goodnight to her, like you just clocked into your hotel room. Mm. On your loneliness, by the way, you could have had holes in there.
Mm.
But you was on your own, being faithful. You're trying to be a real black man. Because we all know black men don't cheat. Right? And you're faced out with your girl, and then you see this. How are you reacting?
What girl?
Yeah, you spit effects right
You
there.
Know I always say this when I come. You ask me something. What girl?
That's a perfect answer, to be honest.
That's it.
But before you get to the part of what girl, what are you doing?
Like, what girl?
No, but you just ended the relationship and you're not doing nothing.
Yes.
Fair enough. Point you just hang up, yeah, man.
Gee, like
I'm not gonna lie.
There's three strikes, yeah. I usually give people three strikes, but there's also fouled out.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
On the first thing, you do some foul shit. That's it.
Foul out the play.
At that point,
that's it. That's it.
Filthy black bitch.
I can't have it.
I'm not gonna lie to you, I might have to poison her and her whole family.
That's the lineage. That's crazy.
Hey, like, fam, evil people like you shouldn't exist, bro. Yeah, what do you mean? You're talking to me like, babe, you're all naked. Like, I'm thinking I'm the only one that's seen this. There's another guy next door that's just been inside of you.
You know what's funny? I'm glad you're screaming this because the girl at the very beginning.
Word.
Yeah.
Nah,
yeah. The girl at the very beginning.
That's crazy.
I didn't say there was anything wrong with the nigga that was fucking her. I'm saying there's something wrong with me being in a relationship when another nigga's fucking her. Does that make sense?
But is that not what's going on in the clip?
It is, but I'd like to be the nigga in the clip, not the nigga that's on FaceTime.
That's crazy.
Alright, cool.
I'm not, okay. I'm not justifying it for the ladies. Don't get me wrong. It's wrong. Foul shit is foul shit, innit? That's the same reason why I'm not doing this while I'm in a relationship. Because if I was in a relationship to keep it a bean, I wouldn't be out there doing shit like that because it's foul.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? But the way I see it is, I'm not doing anything. You're making a decision to come and fuck me, knowing that you're in a relationship. Yeah, you've been honest with me that you're in a relationship, but that's not my responsibility.
No,
that's your responsibility.
No, I'm saying in the sense where you say, I kind of see where she's coming from.
No, but that's about telling her man about...
Okay.
You know what I mean? See that. But no, I don't see where she's coming from in terms of cheating. No. That's not what I was trying to say.
Oh, okay.
You lot misunderstood me.
I did.
I told her that it was wrong. And when this nigga asked me what advice I gave her, I told her, you need to tell this nigga, because when he finds out, regardless, still gonna be fucking upset.
Yeah, okay, cool.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But I'm not gonna not fuck a girl because she's got a boyfriend. Let's put it that way. It's not my responsibility.
I'm not mad at that.
Hey, man. It is what it is. But anyways, is there anything else that anyone would like to add? Because I think that's the end of the podcast now.
Yeah, that's it.
Pretty much.
Yeah,
Alright, I don't know who needs to hear this.
Do
you have one? What? So basically, we have this thing where we go, I don't know who needs to hear this, but blah, 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 blah. It could be like an inspirational quote. Oh, or it could be like you telling off a certain demographic of people. I've got one.
Go on.
I don't know who needs to hear this. Mm. But if your man's not fucking you right, it's better for you to leave the relationship. It is.
That's crazy.
It is. It's just better. Because women who say all of that, I heard of them, after 2 years, the relationship done out anyways, and then they'll go through way more hurt and way more fucking emotional trouble and way more trauma. It's like, if you just been honest from the beginning, you'd have been over this. You know what I mean? But that's fine. Do you have one? If you don't, we can move on.
No, I don't have one.
That's cool.
I don't know need to hear this. Quite only needs to hear this, but ain't nobody care, bro. We keep moving.
Real shit, bro. Bare people out there think that their opinions actually matter more than it actually does. Nobody gives a shit. Nobody does. Your friends might make you seem like your opinion and your perspective to life is very important, but no one gives a shit.
People that enable are. That's pretty peak. If you only got people that enable you, they ain't gonna make it too far.
Exactly. You have one, DeAndre.
Yeah. I don't need to hear this. But if you're not subscribed to Podfellas. I don't know who needs to hear this, but if you're not subscribed to the Podfella
Talk Show,
you're slacking. The entertainment is here.
You need to enjoy it.
Sit back, popcorn. Your shoes. Jump on your bed.
Have it playing while you're fucking. Have it playing while you're cleaning your house. Nonsense. Have it playing while you're cooking.
Give her an extra one for me.
for those of you that might not get that reference, go watch the video of "Would you let another nigga fuck your girl?" Go watch that. Niggas is asking for wild shit, fam. Come on, say give her extra one for me, fam.
I do need to ask him if that was her biological father.
Yeah, you actually need to know.
Because if that was,
Them
people sway that way. That's all I'm gonna say.
Exactly. That man needs to get cancelled still, I'm not even on the internet way, just proper counselling. Leave the house, my guys. come on. That's weird. Now I'm feeling some type of way you listening to me fucking. If you're saying that as my dad, that's bare weird. Anyways, that's
yeah, okay.
The way my man said, the thing was walking. I'll tell you off thing.
That's crazy. Yeah. But anyways, that's the end of the podcast. Thank you very much for staying to the end, guys. Please make sure you like, share, subscribe, do all them things there. Mm-hmm. Do you have the outro, your outro thing written yet?
I still don't have it. I'll do it this week.
Me neither, but I'm just gonna leave you with this, guys. her new nigga ain't new. You just never knew. Boss. Work on yourself, Kings. That's it. Goodbye.
San Diego. honor through Kiara, they were the best of friends. She turned her head and we moved up just like the justice.
I need your all each and every day. If I can't, then I'll fade. And I don't mean to rush, but I ease and fall in love. In my head, I know that that ain't right, but I believe in first sight. Yeah, we can fall in love right here tonight. Run away and be together for life. No more cold December's.